my darlings. So it is currently leg day today, and oh, that's so awkward. I was going to do, there's someone right next to me that I know, so I'm trying to be awkward. He's like the manager at Vitamin Shop, and I'm always in there because I get complete cookies always, so, and he did my competition. Anyway, I guess you're gonna see a downward angle of me. Today is leg day, and I was going to do a lot of glute isolation exercises. But, oh my god, why is everyone and their mom here? I don't know how awkward it's going to be to record, because I do plan on doing hip thrusts. I have not done them in, like, probably a year and a half, because they always hurt my pubic bone. But I realized you can put a freaking padded pad on it to prevent that. So I saw Allie doing that the other day, and I'm obsessed with her. Allie Stone, go follow her on Instagram, the Fit Allie on Twitter. Holla, Allie. So yeah, I'm gonna do that, and I need to work on my glutes like a lot. So let me show you my gym outfit. So this bralette, it's not a bralette, it's like a bra kind of, it's from Forever 21. It was like $12, I think, maybe less, probably less. I don't think I would buy a sports bra from Forever for $12. Anyway, this is from H&M. It was $2.95. And then these pants are freaking awesome. I kind of forgot I had them. They were at the bottom of my gym clothing drawer, and they are from TJ Maxx. I got them like 3, maybe 4 years ago. I used to work out in them always, but they make the booty look bomb. So I'm wearing them for glute day. Convenient, right? And they were probably like, I think they were on sale actually for $10. So this gym outfit is freaking on point and cheap as hell. So highly recommend you check out those stores. And I'm also wearing Converse. They're extremely dirty. I wore them around Europe last year. They were the only shoes I wore, minus like flip-flops, but since we walked like 12 miles a day, I wore these. So they're extremely broken and dirty, and yeah, they're not really white anymore. So there's that. But in my other video, I mentioned why I lived in Chucks. They don't have a compressible sole, but today that doesn't really matter because I'm not going heavy at all. I think for squats, I'm not gonna go under 8 reps. I think that's the game plan. So if I don't record something, I'm sorry. I'll explain it later and try to maybe get footage in the next video, but there is literally like 12 people in this gym. There's usually like 2, so we'll see how it goes.
Something's burning, I can't figure out what. It's either lust or a cloud of dust. Judgment is clouded, must just be the powder from the power of love. But I'm in something I don't know how to get out of. Left my girl in the house alone. Set my soon-to-be spouse alone. And the further I walk, the louder. Pause for a minute to make certain that's what I heard. Cause after all, this is her place, so I give her the benefit of the doubt. I think I might be about to muscle. The thought's scary, yo, though, and it hurts. Brace, hope it ain't, here we go, yo. Cause my head already goes the worst case scenario, though, in the first place. But you confirm my low end, there it is. Should've known when I made it all the way to third base. And that was only the first game, could've made it the home plate. But you slid straight for the dome and dove
face first.
No, you don't understand, I don't do this for anyone ever. Yeah, that ain't what they all say, I'll say. You can suck a softball through a straw, used to be my fiance. So you sucked on Wayne, Andre, and Kanye. LeBron, Akon, J, Little John, Raekwon, Mace, Polo, DeAndre, Dante, Ross, James, Conway, Kwame. Guess I'm getting my good goddamn jigger on, eh? Cause your name I'm Beyonce. But fuck it, I'm moving on, you women are all crack. But I'll probably always keep on playing.
She doesn't love me. No, she don't love me no more. She hates my company. Yeah, she don't love me no more. I tried to get her up out of my head. Left my bags at the door. She screamed she loved me like she never did before. And I told her,
I'm a sucker for love, you a sucker for dick. Sucking dick in your mama tub. Then your granny walked in, told the stupid nigga to duck under the water. He drowned like an abortion. They booked you for manslaughter. You beat the case and I caught you. Sharan is not available. Now leave a message at the tone. Kendrick, don't forget to buy to bury those expensive pills. Your little fucking Ferris wheel. Fucking spinning on me. Fuck you think we gon' get married still. Fucking Mary had a little lamb. This ain't a fairy tale. Fairy god, mama better tell you how I fucking feel. Like you should fucking beat it or fucking eat it while I'm on my period. Now have a blessed day. Bitch, you serious? I'm in the mirror with this look on my face. Curious why you ain't fucking with me. You cut me deep as a Syrian. You know I want you bad as a Benjamin. I'm delirious. I want you bad as the head shattered on George Zimmerman. After the Dillinger hit him diligently and killing him. His mouthpiece for a Cadillac emblem. That's analogy and metaphor for you. I should win a metaphor. All the ways I adore you. This is me talking torture. Yeah, I got some home training. That ain't what you like, ain't it? What about if I was famous as Marshall? What you get for Lacey in the carpool? Cops pull us over. They just wanna know if the gargle see you. I hope she's good enough. Meanwhile, you're chasing her. Chlamydia couldn't even get rid of her. Pity the fool and pity the fool in me. I'ma live with the
game of love.
She doesn't love me. No, she don't love me no more. She hates my company. Yeah, she don't love me no more. I tried to get her up out of my head. Left my bags at the door. She screamed she loved me like she never did before. And I told her,
Sam feeling betrayed, snatched my house key off a keychain. She jumps off eBay from the wires cake. Now she's tasting me with a cheese grater. Here goes that broken record cliche. It's all my fault anyway. She's turning the tables, I'ma be brave. She treats my face like Serato. She cuts and scratches like a DJ. Each day is an instant replay. They say what we display, symptomatic of addict behavior. Back together, but forgot today was her B-day. She cut me off on the freeway, simple misunderstanding. But just as I went to slam on the brakes, that's when I realized that she may be crazy as me. Wait, bitch, cut my fucking brake line. Step on them fuckers 8 times. Still going 73, thank God there's an exit coming up. But the mother F-U-C-K's wrong, would've hit the off ramp. I coasted to a gosh damn hall, hit a fucking tree now. Here she comes at full speed, she's racing. At me, okay, you wanna fuck with me, eh? Snatch a bitch out of car through the window, she's screaming. I body slam on a cement until the concrete gave and created a sinkhole. Bury your sinkhole in it, then pay to have the street repaved. Woke up in a dream state in a cold sweat, like I got hit with a freeze ray during a heat wave. Yes, I eventually caved though, cause she's laying next to me in bed, directly aiming a gat at my head. Woke up again and jumped up like fuck it, I've had it. I'm checking into rehab, I confess I'm a static addict. I guess that's why I'm so clingy. Every girl I've ever had either says I got too much baggage or I'm too fucking dramatic. Man, what the fuck is the matter? I'm just a fucking romantic. I fucking love you, fucking bitch. Combative, possessive, in fact, last time I was mad at an ex, I actually set off chain reaction to tragic events. I said hit the road, and after she left, I sent that bitch a text. I said be careful driving, don't read this and have an accident. She glanced to look at it and ran. Too bad, thought we had a connect. No sense dwelling makes never been a more compelling case than the model covered in Lori yelling mace, who fell from grace. 11 stories for storytelling while the whore was yelling race. But the vocal cords were swelling and her voice was more hoarse than Tori spelling space. Still they swarm the gates of my fancy estates to greet Norman Bates with a warm embrace. Let your Andrea Yates, don't ask me for a date, don't relate. Well the sentiment's great, but wait, think this been a mistake. You wanted to intimidate, I want to intimidate. I have infinite hate and my blood is mainly cause of the game of. Wait, dinner at 8. I have infinite hate in my blood, it's mainly cause of the
game of love.
Alrighty, friends, I just died. I'm like 95% sure I did. So my intent going into the gym this morning was just to isolate glutes. I really didn't have a game plan, like, at all. All I knew was that I was gonna do hip thrusts. That was, like, a for sure thing. As you can see by the videos, I did only do 3 sets of whatever, instead of 4. I did intend on doing 4, but my ass was on fire. And I tried to do the 4th set for almost all of them and just, like, collapsed. So I only did 3 sets, and this was a lot higher volume than I'm used to. I've been training at like 6 sets of 2, just kidding, 6 sets of 2, and like 5 sets of 3, and 5 sets of 5, and all that fun stuff, but not 3 sets of 15 or 3 sets of 12. So yeah, and these are all exercises I haven't done in a hot minute, with the exception of squats. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. All right, friends, I'm outside taking cool nature pics of my post-workout nom-noms. So what I have in there is 1/3 cup of gluten-free oatmeal, cinnamon, a scoop of Vega 1 protein, and it is vanilla flavored. Then I have a no-cal bar. They have 20 grams of protein, 170 calories, which is awesome. And they have, they're by D's Naturals. And this is by D's Naturals as well. It's a tablespoon of fluff butter, which is just protein infused nut butter, but it is plant protein infused. So it's vegan, and 2 tablespoons is 11 grams of protein, which is pretty damn good. But I only have 1 there, so enjoy.